My name is Julian Rubenfein, and I'm from New York City, and I go to school at Stuyvesant High School in Manhattan, and I'm the 2016 Jeans in Space winner. My project was basically proposing that we can use a new assay and a new model system in space to examine how telomere dynamics can change in spaceflight and the implications of that for future space travel. Telomere biology is of interest to researchers, and it has been for a long time because it's hypothesized connections to aging. And so some people believe that when astronauts go into space, the rigors of spaceflight, all of the stresses that get placed on the body, can actually contribute to a sort of premature aging, rapid aging. And so if we can examine how telomere dynamics changing in space can contribute to this, then it can give us some answers about, astronaut health. And then, we need those answers if we ever want to go to Mars, colonize other planets, deep space flight missions, things like this. So today I'm here at New England Biolabs with NEB scientists and Jeans in Space scientists, and we're all working together on preparing the experiments that will actually fly to space. So we're rigorously, testing all of the various parts of the experiments that are actually going to fly up there. And NEB has been extremely generous, and they're helping me prepare everything and using various NEB technologies like the LAMP assay and the Monarch mini prep kit. We're able to do all of this preparation in 2 days, hopefully, so it's going to be great. This whole project, I've been working with Jeans in Space people, and also with a mentor who's a graduate student at MIT, and his name is Denise, and he's been doing literature search with me and helping me plan things out and identify problems and this kind of thing. And he's been a tremendous help, and I couldn't have done any of it without him. My advice to people who are considering applying to Jeans in Space in the future is that you can be very creative imagining different kinds of experiments that can go into space, because the field of space biology and space science in general is really in its infancy, and there is a lot that is, remains to be done before we can go to Mars and go on deep space flight missions and things like this, which means that anything that you can come up with potentially could be a real contribution to the field. So you don't have to be a professor. You can be a high school student and still make a contribution.